Keep in mind while you travel that staying at home also costs money.
But you're on beds. It's a big difference, but I think the cheapest bed I paid for was $7 in a 4-bedroom dorm, including breakfast in Laos. It was a very good dorm because it was pretty new, so the rooms were new, the bed and the toilets, etc. were very new. The breakfast was okay. It was enough to start the day, so no complaints there. So there was around $7 a month. And then I changed in the same place to a private room, including breakfast, and I only paid $10.50. So surprise there. It really is worth the while to ask around, look around, because sometimes if you go up front a reception and it's low season and they don't have many people in the hotel or hostel, they can actually give you a very good rate.
The most expensive beds I had were probably in America and in Switzerland. Because I'm a solo traveler, I have to pay for the private rooms myself, and those costs in Switzerland and America were about €100 a night, especially in America because I was visiting a lot of the national parks, and all the hotels and motels around the national parks have very high prices.
I think the cheapest meal I had was probably $1 or $2 because I love street food. So a lot of times the drink, the beer or the Coca-Cola I had with the dinner was the same price as for the food. So you end up paying $3 or $4 only. I like the taste of street food. It's also a very nice way to meet local people.
My most expensive meal, that would be a big surprise, is probably a buffet I had in Zimbabwe. Oh, okay, I have to admit, it was very close to the Victoria Waterfalls, but then again, it really caught me by surprise. Somebody else made the reservation, so I really didn't have any clue what it will cost, but I'm a long-time traveler already. I was like in my second year already, and then the waiter came up, and I like, I have to pay for one buffet, and I don't know, I drink a beer or cola, I don't know even what it was. And he set the price, and I'm like, yeah, okay, that's very funny, and what is the actual price? And he repeated it, and I'm like looking around the table, and I'm like, what? Did you know that it was this price? Because it's like the same price and going in the Netherlands to a restaurant. So that was a big surprise. So maybe that's also good. Always look at a menu before you go in somewhere. The cheapest transportation I had was with a chicken bus, which only costed me 50 cents. And it was actually more for the most I paid on transportation was probably the rental car in America, because I rented it alone and I rented it for 24 days. So I think including insurance, navigation, etc., I paid like $1,500 for 24 days. It was high season in California. So I know before I went there, a lot of people say like, oh, $10, $15 a day, it will cost it this much. I actually negotiated the price down with €1,000. So actually the starting price was way over 2,000. So negotiating and put on a sad face, maybe, I don't know, maybe they felt sorry for me, but I dropped the price till almost 1,500. But then again, nevertheless, renting car rental is most of the times very expensive. It was me even more expensive than my flights. I think the most expensive flight I had was going in and out of Netherlands to Guatemala. I think I paid $650 for that one. My most expensive activity was actually from Switzerland to the Mont Blanc. I did a house sitting assignment in Switzerland, and I treated myself on my birthday with a very fancy day trip to the Mont Blanc. It was actually not that fancy, but I had a pickup from the apartment. It was in a group. They brought me to Chamonix, so I didn't have to bother to go by public transportation, because then I had to switch trains one or two times, and it would not actually save me that much money, because in the ticket it was already included that they already paid for the cable car, and I didn't have to stand in line to buy the cable car ticket. And it also included a train ticket up to a gletscher, and it included, I think, a bottle of water. So I think the whole day trip cost me 120 or 130 euros. That's very expensive, of course, but going up alone with a cable car, I think it's already over 70 euros. So it would have been also an expensive day if I did it myself. And I looked it up, like how much time would I take me to get there myself and find out all the tickets and stand in line, etc. And I would have probably saved maybe 5 or 10 euros. And I thought that's not worth the while.
Another expensive experience was going on a guided jungle tour in Costa Rica. I think it cost like 90 US dollars to do that. It included a boat trip and a lunch too. I have to say that the groups with the guides were only 6 or 7 people. So you really got a very good one-on-one experience, and we really saw a lot of animals. So at the end, it was totally worth it, but it is still a lot of money for one activity. So I always mix and match everything. So expensive with non-expensive. So also on activities, if I have a very expensive activity day, the day or 2 days after, I try to spend no money or hardly any money on activities. So I go for a swim, go for a walk in the city, read a book, plan everything. There is a lot of times that you also will not spend or hardly any spend any money on activities.
Spending $20,000 a year on traveling is a very doable and realistic number, because I traveled for 2 separate years and both the years cost me around $20,000. I have to say I mixed and matched everything. So I mixed and matched dorms and private rooms, and I mixed and matched expensive countries and non-expensive countries.
Because there's a big difference in prices, of course, from continents to even different countries.
Thanks for watching. I want to share my travel experience, tips, tricks, and lifestyle with you. So I would love if you would subscribe to my channel. Put on a smile, it's universal language.